17. I will show you multiple ways how you do the cross stitch. So first of all, you start with a chain 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Turn your work. Wrap around twice. Skip the first and the second stitch. In the third, you will make a treble crochet. Sorry for the pattern, I wrote treble double crochet, but it should be a treble crochet. Then, chain one, treble crochet around the first skipped stitch. Pull up the loop, pull through, and pull through. Now you have a crossed stitch. Show you one more time. So, wrap around twice, skip the first and the second stitch. In the third, you will put your hook through, pick up the yarn, and pull through two, pull through two, and pull through two. Chain one, twice around the hook, go back to the first skipped stitch. There you go in, pull up the loop, and go through, through, and through. Then you've got two crossed stitches. Now another way. Wrap around twice. Going to the first stitch. Pull up a loop. And pull through. Only one time. Then yarn around. Skip one stitch in the next. Pull up a loop. Pull through one. Then go back up until you have one stitch left. Go. Pull through two, pull through two, pull through two. Chain one, wrap around one time. And then you see here a skipped bar, like a V-shaped stitch. Pull your hook through the first and to the second loop. Pull the yarn up and pull through two, pull through two. There you've got a crossed stitch. So I'll show you one more time. Wrap around twice. Go into the first stitch, pick up your loop, pull through two. Keep the three loops on your hook, yarn around, skip one stitch into the next, pull up a loop, and then you go back up until you have one stitch left on your hook. So every time through two loops, pull through two, pull through two, pull through two, and pull through two. Now chain one, wrap around once. And here you see, I'll show you, here, this bar and this bar, you will crochet underneath them. So, that's number one, and there's number two, and pull through, and then finish your stitch off. That's the second way to do it. Third way, wrap around twice. Pull the hook through the first one, pull up a loop, wrap around, skip one stitch into the next, pull up, and go first back till you have one stitch left, chain one, wrap around, and then you go between those to the back. So you see here a little bar and a V shape, like a little roof, into the roof to the back, like this. Pull up a loop. Pull through, pull through. That's also a way. I prefer this way. I'll show you this way not one more time. Wrap around twice into the following stitch. Pull up once, yarn around, skip one stitch into the next. Pull up, go totally back up till you have one stitch left on the hook. So pull through, pull through, pull through, and pull through. Chain one. And then from the front to the back and pull up a loop and make your double crochet. So you have more ways to do the cross stitch. My way is this way. I prefer to do it like this. So the first kind is to wrap around twice, skip two stitches into the next. You make your treble crochet, chain one, Wrap around twice and go to the first skipped stitch. Pull up a loop and finish your treble crochet. The next one, my favorite. Pull up a yarn over two times, go into the first stitch and pull through one time to pull through two loops. Wrap around again, skip one stitch into the next and pull up until you have one loop left on the hook, chain one and then go into those vertical bars like a little rooftop and make your double crochet. That is my loveliest way to make it. And the other way is exactly the same as mine, only you put your hook through the back, through to the back. So, that's up to you. I will take this out because I will make it like this. And then we'll finish off this row together. Well, I just finished my cross stitch row with treble crochets. I will make my last treble crochet in the last stitch. So I'll skip one and in the last I will make my treble crochet. Like this. Chain one and turn. It could be that you don't have a skip stitch left. That's fine, just put the last stitch with a treble crochet in it. Row 18 says double crochet throughout all stitches. So, I've skipped one stitch, but I won't count it right now. So just leave it like this. I see here, two legs of the treble crochet and a chain one in between. So what will we do? One in the first leg of the treble cross stitch. And one in a chain one space, and the other in the other leg of the cross stitch. That way you will be continuing. So every stitch you will see, you will put one double crochet into it. So in the first leg, in the chain one space, and in the second leg of the cross stitch. Keep repeating this, and we will finish up this row together. So I just finished this row with double crochets in top of all stitches. Please don't forget the chain 4 that you have here. So you count the fourth chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, and in the fourth chain you will make the last double crochet. And then, chain 1, turn your work around. The pattern says you to repeat row 5 and 6. Well, row 5 and 6. Row 5 are all half double crochets throughout this row. So you make half double crochets all the way through up until the last stitch. So you need this to make a little bit of a base for the other stitches to be following. Cross stitch is a nice stitch, but you need to make a little base crocheting around it to give it more strength. If I would crochet directly into another pattern below this cross stitch, your cardigan will be so heavy on those cross stitches that the stitch won't be as beautiful as it is anymore. So please don't forget to make this half double crochet row throughout. So we'll finish off together. I've made all these half double crochets on top of the double crochets from the previous row and I've got my last stitch here. Since I made a chain one and turn and made my directly a double crochet in the first stitch, I have a chain two which I will be crocheting in. So row six repeating. Row six, what does it say? One double crochet in the next two stitches. So in the first you make one double crochet and in the second. Now skip two stitches and we're going to make the corner to corner with half double crochets again. So two stitches skipped, in the third make a double crochet, chain up two, and three half double crochets around the double crochet. One, two, and three, plus a single crochet in the beginning of your double crochet. Again, skip two stitches in the third. Make a double crochet, chain two, make three half double crochets around the double crochet, that's number two, number three, and make a single crochet in the base of the double crochet. So, corner to corner, repeating this, and we'll finish off together. So I finished this row almost. All those little points here, then you're correct. Pattern says you to do one double crochet over the last two stitches. So you skip one stitch, and in the last you make each one double crochet. For me, it's my chaining turn, is my last stitch to make a double crochet into. So chain one and turn your work around. Now we are facing the correct size side again. Here you see the ribbing which you have been made before. Oh, my yarn is stuck somewhere. There it is. So now, what does the pattern say you to do? Row 7, to be repeated 2 times. Chain 1, I made my chain 1 and turn my work. So in the first 2 stitches you make each 1 double crochet. That's number 1 and there's number 2. If you rather prefer to make chain 3, make here chain 3 and 1 double crochet in the next. Skip into the third stitch. So third half double crochet from the previous row, there you make one single crochet, chain up 2, and make 3 half double crochets around the last stitch here, around the last post. That will be the chain 2 from the previous row. 3 half double crochets around the chain 2. 1, 2, and number 3. Skip directly to the next 1, 2, third stitch from the previous row. So that will be the third half double crochet. There you make one single crochet in top, chain 2, and make 3 half double crochets around the chain 2 from the previous row. 1, 2, 3. Again, single crochet in the third half double crochet from the previous row, chain 2, and 3 half double crochets around the chain 2 from the previous row. 1, 2, and 3. I'll show you how it looks like this. So we'll be repeating this throughout this row and we'll finish off together again. So single crochet, chain 2, and 3 half double crochets around the chain 2 from the previous row. 1, 2, and number 3. So I almost finished this row, should be row 7 2 times, so this is the first time I've done row 7. We finish off together, in the last 2 stitches each 1 double crochet. So that's 1, and in my chain 1, another 1. So there's 2 double crochets at the end, chain 1 and turn your work around. And then repeating row number 7. So in the first 2 stitches you make each 1 double crochet. That's number 1. In the third half double crochet previous row you make a single crochet, chain up 2, 3 half double crochets around the chain 2 from the previous row. 1, 2, third half double crochet previous row you make a single crochet, chain 2, 3 half double crochets around the chain 2 from the previous row, and again 1 single crochet in the third half double crochet previous row, chain up 2, and 3 half double crochets around the chain 2 from the previous row, 2 and number 3. This to be repeated throughout this row and we'll finish off together. So I almost finished row 7 for the second time. Again, I'll end up with having 2 double crochets left over. So there I'll make each one and make 1 double crochet into it. 1 and number 2. Chain 1 and turn your work around. The pattern says now to be repeated row number 8. 1 double crochet in the first 2 stitches. 1 and number 2, and then 1 double crochet on the 3 half double crochets from the previous row. So that's number 1, number 2, and number 3. Skip the chain 2 and skip the single crochet if you have one, or you think you have one. Well, this is the one here. That one you will skip, and then the next three half double crochets you make one double crochet on top of them. 1, 2 and number 3. I skip chain 2 and I skip the single crochet into the half double crochets of the previous row, each one one double crochet. Repeat this row throughout and we'll finish up together. So this is how it looks like. Good luck. So I finished this row almost. It was row 21, but repeat row 8. Last two stitches left, then I make each one double crochet into it. So that's number 1 and that's number 2. Chain 1 and turn your work. Now row 21 says double crochet in the next two stitches. So it's the first and the second. Now chain 2, skip 2 stitches, and then the next you make 1 double crochet. Again, chain 2, skip 2 stitches, and then the next double crochet. Chain 2, skip 2 stitches, and then the next 1 double crochet. Repeat this and we'll finish off together. Well, I almost finished this row. This is how it should look like. Last two stitches you make each one double crochet. So that's 1 and that's number 2. Chain 1 and turn your work around. Row 23. 1 double crochet in the next two stitches. So here 1 double crochet and there 1 double crochet. Then the repeating. Chain 1, 2 double crochets in the chain 2 space. 1 and 2. Chain 1, skip the double crochet, make 2 double crochet in the chain 2 space. Another time, chain 1, skip the double crochet, 2 double crochets in the chain 2 space. Chain 1. This to be repeated throughout the row and we'll finish off this row together. So, row 23 should look like this. Now, last two stitches, each one double crochet. Number 1 and number 2. Next row, chain 1, turn. Row 24. 1 double crochet in the next 2 stitches. So, here's the first and the second. Then, chain 2 and 1 double crochet in the chain 1 space. So, chain 2. 1 double crochet in the next chain 1 space here. Chain 2, 1 double crochet in the chain 1 space. Chain 2, 1 double crochet in the next chain 1 space. We'll be repeating this row throughout and we will finish off together. So, this is how this row should look like. We finish up together. Last 2 stitches, each 1 double crochet. That's number 1 and number 2.